God, check it, check it, yo. Anybody, any mayor ever thrown an inauguration party like this before?
Never, my brother, never. This is the baddest jam New York City has ever seen.
Yo, check it out. Yo, we the kings of New York now. Listen, you the youngest mayor that's ever been elected. Like, you went from rapper to hip-hop mayor. This is freaking believable, yo.
You can tell me, man.
Only in America, yo. Only in America. Listen, the only thing that the press is talking about is our inauguration party. Yo, this joint is lit, B.
Yo, but check it, man. Check it. We got to kill these parties, man. We got to start looking at taking care of the people's business, man. You know, we're here for a reason.
Listen, Tarsus, man, we are the people. The people have spoken. Look, we won by a landslide, man. Xerxes is king. We can go another week. Everybody is enjoying this right now, man. Come on.
Yo, guys, listen. It's cool. It's good. But, you know, the parties do have to end. Yo, Tarshish, woo. Tarshish, you a wise man, yo. That's why we keep him around, right, guys? Without him, we wouldn't even be here right now. But really, just think about it. I am the youngest mayor in New York ever.
Do you?
And I'm in charge now. It was good.
Absolutely, absolutely, man. But listen, I ran your campaign, man. Yo, from here, we going to governor, and then guess where we going? We going to Barack him. President of the United States, baby. It's coming. Here, take this glass, man. Take this glass. Look, we going to eat. We going to drink. We going to be merry, player.
Yo, listen, I'm good. Today's the last day. This is my last drink, all right? I'm done, all right? I've had enough. Whew. But now check it, though. There's this dance I want everybody to see that my fiance Vashti prepared, yo. Yo, get everybody's attention. Get everybody quiet, man. Like, come on.
Come here. Yo. Quiet down in the room. Now, listen, the king. Listen, our mayor wants to thank each and every one of you for coming out tonight, right? So we're going to end this bad boy in about 2 hours or so. But before you go, we have a special surprise from our future First Lady. Now, not only is Vashti beautiful and intelligent, she is a very talented hip-hop artist and dancer. Now, wait until you see her moves. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, members of the press, I introduce to you the Queen. Was writing about. That's all they were talking about. But you know what? But you, man, listen, you had to include Vashti. Man, I told you when you first got with that chick, she wasn't even all there, bro. Come on, man. A freaking crazy Latina Jamaican, man. her mama Puerto Rican, and her daddy from Jamaica.
Yo, dude, yo, we need to chill, man. You need to bring it down a level, okay? Obviously, she didn't like the way you introduced her, man. Right? No woman wants to be introduced like she's a piece of meat, man. And you did that, and you do it every time. We got to look at how we treat her, man.
Listen, we can't get this a few weeks, man. Everybody knows that she dissed him, man. She dissed him in front of the whole wide world. What are we supposed to do? Don't be quiet now.
Yo, guys, that's enough, all right? I hear y'all. Just give me a couple of days to think about it. Just give me 2 days, all right? And I'll get back to y'all with what we're going to do, all right? Just please.
Listen, man, a few days? We don't have a few days, man. Your poll numbers are going to plummet if you let that ghetto-ass girl diss you like that, bro. Come on, man. Then, on top of it, you're setting a bad example to the people. Remember, man, we're not just in this for the mayor, man. We in here for the governorship and then the president of the United States, man. Come on.
Hey, man, do me a favor. Stop referring to her as a ghetto girl. Tashish, what do you think about this, man?
Oh, man. Well, look, it's obvious, man, that your relationship with her is over. You know, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. It's dead. She's not talking, and she's telling you publicly to kiss her ass. You can't take that. She's not giving you any 411, man, or what's going on. Nothing. So why do we send out a press release? You know, let everybody know that you and her, you're having some problems. You know, you're going back and forth. And as you decide to just drop her, you know, hot potato, drop her. People understand. Something like this happens all the time. All the time.
Yo, you know what, man? Forget the press release. What you need to do is this. You need to dump this chick, man, and quietly start dating again. That's what you need to do.
No. Look, yo, I am not ready to start dating again, all right, man? Look, how about this? Look, I'll just stay single. You know, I'll do what I gotta do. I think that the easiest way to get it done.
Listen, man, what you need to do is this. You need to get used to dating again. You know why? Because people trust married people, bro. Not singles, man. Not singles.
Yo.
No, this is true, man. As crazy as he sounds, that's true.
But guys, I hate dating. Like, how y'all expect me to attend to the people's business and go out and find some girl and marry? Like, that's too much. I can't do all that, man.
Look, bro, you're worrying yourself too much. You ain't got to worry about none of that. That's what you got me for, man. Listen, I'll let everybody know that you're looking for a new queen. So then they'll start sending us their very, very best. So then you take a look and you pick and choose which one you want. Then me, I create a little buzz, you know, from dating to marriage. Come on, man. They going to love it, man. Listen, social media, the press, newspaper, radio, you can't beat that.
You know, hey, man, I actually like that. That's actually a really good idea. Yo, Tosh, what do you think about that, man?
You know, man, as crazy as that crap sounds, it just might work.
Yo, wait. Mordecai, you've been quiet since the inauguration, man. What's on your mind? What's good, brother?
I've only been quiet, man, because your chief of staff told me that I shouldn't speak to anyone, not even you, I'm spoken to.
And ain't nobody speak to your ass yet. Mordecai don't know nothing about politics, man. He might mess around and say the wrong thing.
Yo, but hold on. How you gonna tell my own homeboy not to even speak to me? How that work?
Look, man, as your chief of staff, it is my duty to protect you. That's it. I'm here to protect you. Now, listen, you got a second, man. Can we talk alone? I need to holler at you about something.
Gentlemen, excuse us for a few minutes, please.
Sure.
Thank you. What?
Listen, man, look. No pun intended, no harm, man. But you know, your boy Mordecai, yo, that cat's slow, man. Listen, he ain't even got it all together, bro.
Listen.
We can't risk our political future on this dude, man. We can't risk it.
I need you to be easy when it comes to Mordecai, all right? I knew him before I knew you. All right, and he's been loyal every step of the way. Now you, my top dog. You know, when you walk into a room, my chief of staff, people rise to their feet. Look, the Honorable Haman. How does that sound, man? Sound good, right? Yeah, yeah, I know you. Yeah, uh-huh, I knew you would like it, man. So yeah, be easy.
I love it.
Hadassah, you here?
Yes, Uncle Dad. I'm in my room studying for my bar exam next year.
Wow. Next year. And you're studying now. Fantastic. Can I speak with you for a moment?
Sure. So, how is it at work with the first hip hop and youngest black mayor in New York City ever?
Wait a minute. You really like him? You really like him?
I can't wait for you to introduce me to him.
Well, I'm not going to introduce you to him. Not yet. Listen, I want you to meet him on your own.
But how can that happen, Uncle Dad? I mean, I don't even travel in a circle.
You still want to model?
Of course. You know I love modeling.
Okay. You think you could stick to training for about a year, then outperform all the top models from around the world for a shot at money, power, fame, and respect?
Let me put this law book down. I guess I could do training for a year.
Now listen, I can't guarantee you anything, but if you get this, it will change our lives. Listen, I want you to call this woman at the mayor's mansion, okay? Her name is Mrs. Haggai. Now, she's in charge of this event. It's the biggest fashion show that City Hall has ever seen. And the prize is astronomical. But only one girl, can get it.
That's so exciting. And I love competition, so I'm gonna call her right now.
Good. Goodbye. Don't mention me. Don't say you know me or anything like that.
Nothing?
Can you make it on your own?
I can. Don't worry about me. Those girls ain't got nothing over me.
Man, listen. Oh, my goodness. These are the most beautiful women I've ever seen before in my life. Listen, did you see anyone that you wanted to meet? Anybody you interested in? What about that first one, man? She was hot now. She was hot. Wasn't she?
Oh, yeah. She, oh, man. She was all right. Yeah. They all were all right, man. Yeah. Yo, how did that first one even get in the lineup? She was clumsy and somewhat obese, you know, girl.
Let me tell you, man. Let me inform you, my brother. It's called politics. Okay? Remember that. It's called politics. Happens all the time. Somebody Haman knew, somebody named Hagar, Hagee.
You know
the woman, huh? Yeah. He had her accept her, put her in the competition, man. Happens all the time, man. Politics.
Listen, I feel you. Whew. But honestly, I am bored. Like, it doesn't show on my face, right? Gosh. Yo, I really need some coffee. Like, if y'all could hook me up with some coffee, that would be great. Like, please.
All right, man. You know, give me a second, man. I'll send out for some, okay?
Yo, appreciate you. Thank you.
Be back in a few.
Thank you.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, our last model for the evening.
Thank God. Oh, yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Esther Hadassah.
She is awesome, man. She is great.
See? Now, that one right there, she is wonderful.
She's mine. Together all over the world, from the hood to Japan, have her two cool girls. What? It's all love, what? Give it up,
what? What happens in my life turned upside down? Chicks that blew your mind, ding. The second
round,
original track ending.
Well, you know, we did it. we accomplished what we wanted. He loves that girl, man. He adores her.
Yeah, he sure does, man. Listen, this dude has strange taste. I'm telling you, that boy got some strange taste.
Yeah,
he does. Anyway. But anyway, look, man, I wanted to holler at you about something. I need your advice, man. You got a second?
Yeah, man, go for it. What is it?
So check it out. Every time I go anywhere in New York, when people see me, they rise as they would any judge or a person who has the honor of being honorable, right?
Okay.
But Xerxes, boy, man, that boy's Slow Joe, man.
Slow Joe? You mean Mordecai?
Whatever that African Jamaican's name is, man.
Yo, the brother's Nigerian, man. He's Nigerian, okay?
Yo, whatever, man. But listen, that guy won't stand. I went into a room full of people the other day, and they all stood except him. Man, I'm tired of that boy disrespecting me like that, man. For real, yo. I sent some people from my cabinet to go over and talk to him. This dude refuses to stand when I come into a room, man. I don't know what the hell his problem is.
What did he say? I'm sure you asked him, what kind of BS did you give you, man? Huh? What?
What kind of BS? Check this out.
Yeah.
He told them he won't stand because his damn feet hurt. Can you believe it?
His feet.
His feet.
His feet.
His feet, damn it.
His feet?
Yo, look,
oh,
man.
My God. His feet.
I don't even see nothing funny right now. Ain't even nothing funny. This dude is in charge of sanitation. He should be the first one standing in the room when I come in, man. Look, he stands with Xerxes coming in the room. Ain't nothing wrong with his feet then. So what the hell is the problem?
Yo, guys, I am having a wonderful time with Esther. Yo, this cool. Look, we laugh, we talk. It's like we know each other for like 50 years or something, you know?
Wow. But check it out, man. Did she like the ring that Tasha's got it?
Yo, she loved it. Look, listen, you guys are the best. Thank you so much for that, man.
You know, man, we searched all over for that ring, man. You know, we went uptown, downtown.
I appreciate you, bro.
We did a special order to eBay, the whole bit.
Thank you, man.
But let me tell you something, man. You know, I spoke to the DA the other day. Right?
Oh, true, yeah.
Yeah. And you know, she's stepping down as soon as you find a successor.
Mm-hmm.
We spoke about those Africans who supposedly was plotting your assassination.
Yeah.
You know, she's planning to throw the book at them.
Good, good.
Well, hold up, man. Let me ask you this. How did you even find out about that? They're normally like a tight-lipped community. So how did that happen?
I think it was my fiance's, honestly, I don't know.
Okay.
How's everybody enjoying lunch?
Oh, Mordecai, my God, Mordecai. Yo, come on in, man. Have a seat. How you feeling today, man?
Look, you know we uncovered a plot against the mayor, right?
I'm aware.
Hey, I bet you are, freaking Africans.
They're Africans, I know.
Yeah, your community.
Wait a minute, Heyman. What are you trying to do here, man? What are you implying, huh?
What I'm trying to do?
Yeah.
I'm protecting our future president. That's what I'm doing. Those two men who are plotting against the mayor, plotting his assassination, live in your community. Am I correct?
Yo, how would I know where he lives?
Yeah. Listen, I already spoke to the DA, right? Yeah, I did. I already spoke to the DA. One of them live within 3 miles of you.
And what the heck? What you trying to say, son?
Yo, first of all, man, don't be sonning me like that, boy. Secondly, I don't think this dude should be sitting at the table with us any longer, man. I don't like his vibe. I don't like his attitude. I don't like none of that. Listen, Xerxes, I think you need to find somebody else to run the sanitation, man, because he ain't it.
It's not that serious, man.
Y'all don't know those guys. Yo, how dare you say I don't have nothing to do with that? How dare you insinuate something like that? I love Xerxes.
Man, it's a shoot bitch, nigga.
Hey man, what are you doing, man? Yeah. Take it easy, though. You know, we're not gonna have that crap in here. What's wrong with you?
Let's get it.
Let me get out of here.
Yeah, get on the
plane. Jail for real, nigga.
Was that necessary? Like,
yeah, of course it was necessary, man. All of that was all that guilt built up on the inside. You see, my DA is going to make a connection between him and those conspirators. He ain't even got to lie no more about it, man. He's about to get caught.
Hershey's, man, you're too quiet, man. You gonna let him talk to your boy like that?
Look, listen.
What's with you, man?
Listen, look, I don't even know what's going on, man. I'm still trying to figure things out. I don't know where all this came from. Like,
yo, man, I'm out of here, man. I thought you had a pair. Suddenly I'm not hungry anymore.
Tarshish, come on, man. It's not.
No, man, I'm out. I'm out.
Yo, to take your punk ass on then, bro. Bye.
Yo, dude. Who the hell you think you talking to?
Man, I'm talking to
you. Better
guys.
Watch it, man.
Guys.
You know, you got to have your mouth right to check your ass can cash.
Guys.
I don't know who you dealing with.
Check because I'm the bank, boy.
It's yo, brother.
We'll see about that, okay?
Yeah, see it. Deuces, punk.
Punk ass.
Yo, listen, man. Listen. You know, you're my man and all, right? But look. He will not be around for the re-election campaign. I guarantee it, man. I guarantee it. Look, there's a certain people dispersed among the people in all the boroughs to keep themselves separate. Their customs are different from those of all other people. And they don't obey city laws. Now, it is in my mayor's best interest that we don't tolerate any of this foolishness any longer. Now, if it pleases you, the king, let's make a commission to destroy them.
Whoa.
Okay, Okay, wait. Not destroy them, but let's reevaluate current policies. How about that? Policies on their communities, take away their voting rights, their finances, and then we can ship some of their asses back to Africa if you want. Whatever you want to do, Chief, I got you. Think about it.
Hello? Pick up. Pick up. Pick up.
Hey, Uncle Dad.
Hello?
How are you?
Hello?
Look, I'm sorry you can no longer sit in his circle. That Haman is a devil.
Oh, man. I'm not worried about it. I'm doing fine. Fine, child. Oh, my God. Listen, I miss you at home, but I guess... I believe this is the best place for you.
Uncle Dad, it is like nothing I've ever imagined. I mean, it's like a dream come true. I have people waiting on me and I get every single thing I could possibly want.
Hadassah, I need you to talk to the mayor. He put out an immigration policy that if they implement it, I wound up getting sent not just out of the country, but back to Uganda. And I made too many enemies there and they'll kill me, man. It's an entire community of us will wind up going back and probably slaughtered. Okay. Haman!
Look, you know the mayor doesn't want me discussing any of the city's business or policies, so I just stay in my place and I study for my exam. I mean, I only see the guy once or twice a week. Truthfully, I haven't even seen him in the last month. I'm sorry. I can't just go up to him like that.
Don't think that because you are in the king's house, you alone of all the Africans will escape. For if you remain silent at this time, relief for the Africans will arise from another place. But you and me, Adassa, you and me, your father's family will perish. We'll perish. And I just, please let us pray. Let us pray now, let us pray.
Families today.
as we cry out loud. Father, just forgive us. Hear us when we say, we'll give you, give you, give you everything. Our lives and souls today.
Amen. Amen.
Go. Gather all of the brothers and sisters of New York City and fast for me. Do not eat or drink for 3 days, day or night. I and my attendants will do the same. When this is over, I will go to the mayor. He's already made himself clear about this. And if I lose his love, then I just lose his love.
Yeah. Come on, y'all.
Hey, Queen, what's up?
May I speak to you for a minute?
Yeah, sure. What's your request? Up to half the city you asked for it, it'll be yours.
Well, if it pleases my man, the mayor, let the mayor, along with Haman, come to dinner tomorrow night.
You got it. Are you sure you want Haman there too?
Oh, no doubt. So, dinner tomorrow night.
Dinner tomorrow night.
Correct.
But wait, hold on, wait. What is it that you want to ask about? Is it the bar? I know you've been studying really hard. I know you're going to pass.
I'll tell you everything at dinner.
Dinner tomorrow.
Hey, yo! Yo, yo, yo. Check this out, yo. Check this out. Check this out. Look, the king invited me to dinner with me, him, and his woman. Ah, nobody else. And not even you. Just me. I'm going to be running this town soon enough. I swear, man, I'm going to make my friend the permanent DA. Permanent. Permanent DA. And we're going to, yo, hold up. What are you doing here?
He was giving me some information, you know? Just reporting some important stuff just came across my desk that's gonna put a whole shift on this whole situation.
Well, yo, you finished giving your report, boy? Then get your ass on up out of here then.
Yo, dude. This is my office. He came to see me. He's welcome here. Don't you ever talk to my people like that.
Look here, man. I talk to whoever, however, and whenever I want to. You better stay away from that dude, man. You better stay away from him. My DA is going to put him in jail.
In jail for what? For what?
Yeah, just watch. If we don't ship him back to his country first.
Yo, man, what do you want? You know, suddenly you bring a bad stench to my office, man. It smells like crap in here. What's with you?
Smells like crap, huh? Must be your top lip. But you know what? That's cool, bro. That's cool. That's cool. Listen, man, I don't want to beef. I don't want to argue. I just came here to share some good news with you. I'm being invited to dinner with Xerxes and Esther. Now, he's going to give me a promotion. I'm sure of it. I wanted us, me and you, you and I, to bury the hatchet. But every time I see that freaking Mordecai, man, it just makes my skin boil.
Bury the hatchet, huh? That sounds like a good idea, burying the hatchet. If it's in your damn skull, nigga. Now you're done. Get out of my office, man. Get the hell out of here.
I want to be in your little corny office.
Get out.
Whatever, man. Hey, Zurich? Hey, baby, what's up, man? How you doing? How's your day going? Your day's going good, babe? Good, 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 good. So listen, I just want you to know that I love you. I love you with all my heart. Our lives right now is about to change. Change it even for the better right now. See, the mayor, listen, he invited me to dinner tonight to be his only guest with him and his fiance. Yes, yes, yes. Isn't that amazing, babe? Isn't it? Listen, probably more money and a promotion. Yo, I'm killing it right now, baby. I'm killing it. Killing it right now. But you see, my only problem is this. That damn guy, Mordecai, man. Every time I see this dude, man, he just turns my stomach. He makes me sick. Yeah, I know. But listen, he's a waste of my time. He's a waste of everybody's time. But you know what? I say we should do this. I say we lock all of their asses up. I'm already ahead of you. Yeah. See, I spoke to the DA, and we're going to find a way that we can lock them up for at least 50 years. Get them 50 years worth of charges. That's what we're going to do. Yeah. But we don't know what the charges are going to be yet. We're still working on that part. But setting somebody up like him is a public service to the people in the community. That's all I got to say about it. Yeah, babe. Come on now. Our books are clean. You know, they don't have to dig so far that they'll find nothing on our business if they do any digging. Trust me. Yeah, babe. You know, I'm just calling to let you know. No need to worry. No need to panic. I got you. You got it all covered. Later.
Look, brother, man. You the man and all that. You top dog. But I had my people do a little investigation into this assassination plot against you. And you thought it was Haman, right?
Yeah. He even said that, you know, he... Yeah.
Well, whatever he said was a lie, bold-faced lie. He's playing you, man. He's playing you big time. Yeah. He tried to tell you, but Haman wouldn't let him get near you.
Who tried to tell? Wait, what?
He wouldn't let him get near you. And let me ask you this. You heard it from your fiance too, right? Your girl?
Yeah.
That's because Mordecai told her. Don't look surprised. You know that African community, man, they're small and they're tight-knit. And as soon as he found out, he dropped the dime, man. He told her immediately.
So Mordecai saved my life.
There it is.
Damn. What do I do for a guy like that? Like, how can I thank somebody like that?
I don't know, man. That's on you, bro. I don't know. I got the bounce, man. I got things to do. Good luck with that.
I'll talk to you later, man.
All right, man.
Yo.
Hello? Yo, oh. Yo, Haman. Sorry to bother you, man. I know it's kind of late. Forgive me. Are you busy? I gotta... Something I want to ask you.
Oh, man. Hey, what's up, man? Never too busy for you. What's going on?
All right, cool. Haman, what should the mayor do for a man that he wants to honor?
Hold on one second, Mr. King. Can you give me one second? I'm having some technical. I'm just putting on mute.
Yeah, go ahead.
Hey, Zurich, baby. Hey, baby. Listen, real quick. Look, I got the mayor on the line right now, right? Stay there. You don't even have to come over here. You don't even have to come. Just listen to this. He wants to honor me. He wants to honor me. That's right. He wants to honor me. Who is there that the king will honor more than me? Nobody. I'm sure that the king is talking about honoring me. I'm sure of it. Okay. Hold on. Don't say anything. I'm going to connect the calls and I'm going to put the phone on speaker. Just hold on. Be quiet. Hey, Mr. Mayor. My bad, man. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Issues with the phone, man. I apologize. But listen, man. This is a great day. But here's what I think. Do this for the man the mayor loves to honor. First, give him a small expense account so that he could buy a few top-of-the-line suits, you know, so he can get all nice and jazzy and anything like that. But then get him 24/7 access to limousine service and a driver.
All right.
But then, you know, just to add to that, also let him lead in the next parade. You know, I think it'll be really good with that too, right?
The Christmas parade, you're right.
Yeah, absolutely. But then, you know, you do that just to make sure that everybody knows that this is because he helped you, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay, got you. Now, last but not least, and to top it all off, when you run for governor, put him on your ticket to run for lieutenant governor.
Hold on, let me write that down. Wait, hold on. Yo, this sounds good. This is exactly what I'm going to do. This makes sense. Yeah. Hey, man, you there? You got kind of quiet, man. You good?
Oh, I'm here, sir. Mr. Mayor, just give me one second. Just hold on. Phone issues again, man. I just got to put you on mute.
All right, just hurry up, please.
Thanks. Baby, listen. Tell the kids, tell everybody right now, yo. Look. Your husband is going to be the bigger man in this town. You know what I'm saying? Listen, I can't freaking believe it, yo. Chauffeur driven, limousine, mayor. Oh my God. Yeah, me. That's right, me. I can't take it no more, yo. I'm ready to cry right now because of the excitement. Damn, life is great right now. Hey, hold on. Hey, Mr. Mayor, you there?
Yeah.
Hey, man. I apologize, man. I'm so sorry, man. These Wi-Fi issues, man. You know, I got a phone's not good. The service not good. I truly apologize.
I got you.
But listen, man. I'd be very honored to.
I got to run, all right? But let me just say this, all right? When you come in tomorrow, I don't want you working on anything but this, all right? I need it all complete by the end of business day. You feel me? I actually need it done before the parade because we're going to let him come in for the Christmas parade and I want him coming right before Santa Claus, all right? Oh, and I want a proclamation for me giving him the keys to the city. That sound good?
Oh, you got it, sir. You got it right away.
Okay. Yep.
Listen, should I also prepare a speech for this very important person?
A speech. Keeping it honest with you, I don't think a speech is a good idea. He seems kind of shy.
Oh, Mr. Mayor, come on, man. I assure you that I can handle a small speech.
You know what? Fine. Okay. You'll give the speech, right? Just give a short introduction, a little bio, all right? And just let the world know how much Mordecai means to me and how much he means to this whole entire administration, all right?
Mordecai?
Yes, Ashley. Matter of fact, make sure you reach out to him and let him know what we're planning to do. Because, you know, it's the holiday season. I don't want him leaving the town or anything like that. So make sure he knows what we're doing so he doesn't leave town, please.
Mordecai?
Yes, you're taking long to answer. Look, he's going to get everything he deserves. All right, man? I got to go. I'll talk to you later.
What's the matter, Heyman? You don't like the food? I mean, I gave the chef the day off and cooked it myself.
That's probably the problem. No, I'm good. I'm just not feeling too well today.
Yo, man, come on. Perk up, all right? Don't ruin our dinner. Thank you. Fix yourself, man. Anyway, my queen, what is it that you want to ask me, all right? You know that whatever you ask for, it's already yours. I love you so much. You ask for half the city, I'll make sure that you get it, all right? Whatever you want, baby, just tell me.
Anything? You sure?
am I? Girl, I do not say what I don't mean. Tell me.
All right, then. Well, before I go, I want a huge wedding celebration. One like Princess Markle had. Can you make that happen for me?
Of course. That's an easy one. Go on. What else?
And you know, I used to intern at the DA's office when I was in law school. So now I've passed the bar and I just...
I know. I get it. I don't. You don't have to say anymore. You want to be assistant DA. Of course, baby. You got it.
No. I don't want to be assistant anything. You're the youngest mayor. I want to be the youngest DA.
Oh, hell no. We definitely can't do that, man.
So you're in charge of the DA now. I didn't know that.
Maybe in a few years. You know, we have someone there who is quite competent right now. Thank you.
Babe.
Girl, you are something else. Of course, you got it.
What about my girl? What about my girl who's a DA?
Listen, bro, she's resigning. I mean, I actually respect her. I expect her letter of resignation by tomorrow night. My baby's a new DA.
Listen, man, the people ain't gonna like that.
Well, when they see how well I prosecute a case, they will. And I was the best in my class.
The best in your class? But you haven't even done one case yet. Not even a freaking parking ticket.
Well, I will before I go. And I have plans to prove it. Let me tell you about the Holy Ghost.
Let me tell you about the Holy Ghost. That's what you feel when I hit every note. See, I had it since I was very small. See, there's no way I could ignore the call. I'm on assignment, got a heavy load. No, it ain't easy walking down this road. I've got a story, that's what I've been told. Mama said, with it, girl, you good as gold. See, let me tell you about the Holy Ghost.
Wow. Okay. But wait a second. Before you said that, you said before you go. Why do you keep saying before you go? You ain't going nowhere. You're my girl forever.
Well, if you love me and really want me around, I ask that you let me stay. And that you let my people stay too.
Your people?
Look, I wouldn't even bother you with this, but our lives are on the line. I mean, we left as opponents to our government, and if we go back, they will kill us.
Wait, ain't nobody gonna kill you.
If you send me back to Africa, they will.
Oh.
Oh, you didn't know that I'm African too.
Nah.
There you have it.
Your new immigration policy is specifically aimed at Africans in my community because of some fake assassination plot orchestrated by someone in your administration. I mean, they did this because they wanted to be governor and president themselves instead of you. If this policy is enacted, my uncle and I will be deported and they will kill us. But your guy knew that the whole time.
Wait, baby. You think, wait, somebody's trying to manipulate this administration? And in the process, try to hurt you too? Who would even try something like that?
The man against us, our enemy, is this wicked Haman.
Who?
Whoa.
Hell no.
Hold on, man.
Hell no.
Wait, I can explain.
Oh, can you?
Explain. Esther, please.
I'd love to hear this.
Please don't do this. Please don't do this, Esther. Please don't do this.
You know, look, there's no point in begging.
Listen, none of these things were targeted at you. You got to believe me right now. I love and respect you. It was all targeted at that at that freaking retard that the mayor would let around him all the freaking time.
Retard, please enlighten me.
Yeah, that retard, that freaking Mordecai, that's who. He's slow, and him being around the mayor would drag down his poll numbers. Mm. Look, I was gonna have my girl, the DA, put him in jail for a very, very, very long time. Mm. Now, this way, he wouldn't stop the mayor's chances of rising, the chances of us rising together. Look, I will take him all the way to the presidency. And you know what? Think about this. And you will be the first lady of the United States. Now tell me, how does that sound to you? Don't you just love it?
Picture it. I don't know if you realize, but that retard you keep referring to, that's my uncle who raised me. He's like a father to me.
I'm sorry. I didn't know. I really didn't know.
But you knew he was a man of God and you chose to go against him anyways. You stupid fool. You can't beat God.
Listen, please forgive me. Please
Don't worry, because when I'm done prosecuting you, I plan on prosecuting them too. You guys are all crooked. They talk about your schemes in my neighborhood. Absolute power crabs. Absolutely. Every single one of you are going to jail.
Please, Queen, please have mercy. Please have mercy.
Oh, just get away from me.
Please.
You are coming too close to me.
Hold on. You would even try to attack my queen in my own house? Yo, bro, you got some nerve for real, man.
Xerxes, what's going on here?
Yo,
where is he?
Arrest this fool.
Done.
What? Arrest me? Arrest me for what?
As the new DA, you were implicated in the assassination plot against the mayor. You're looking at 20 to life.
Listen, man, you can't prove none of that right now. None of it.
Oh, I can and I will. You know, you tried to dig a grave for my Uncle Mordecai and you should have read your Bible. It clearly states when you dig one grave, you better dig two.
Yo, I don't even want to hear this anymore. Yo, Tarshish, get this guy out of here. Please get him out of here.
Come on, nigga.
Don't do that, man.
Oh, man. Yo, man. Listen, I want to thank you for taking care of my niece.
Yo, it's no problem at all, man. I guess we're family now, right?
No. No. We always have been fam. Love you to pieces, man.
Yo, I love you too, man. But actually, as a matter of fact, for obvious reasons, there's a vacancy in my administration. I'm looking for a new chief of staff, obviously. So have you ever thought about being chief of staff?
I don't need no chief of staff. I don't need no maintenance and sanitation, man.
I will take that as a yes, my friend. Look, don't worry about it. I'll teach you everything you need to know. I got you, man.
Yo, I'm down, baby. I'm down.
It's going to be great, brother. It's going to be great.
Oh, second term, my brother. Second term. We busted wide open, man. I think society calls that what? A landslide?
Clean sweep.
Clean sweep, that's right. And you, young lady, what can we say about you? You won your court case against Haman, whatever the hell his name is, it really doesn't matter right now. The judge gave him 125 years.
128, but who's counting?
Who's counting?
His wife only got 20 years, and I'll start prosecuting the kids next week.
Well, I'll listen, enough of all that business talk. Tonight, we must celebrate.
Everybody, get up on the floor. We're going to party like it's 2099.
Bursting from my heart.